Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Feng Xue from Beijing National Day School. Happy to meet you. And now we are going to talk about two types of articles, expositive essays and argumentative ones. 今天呢，我们将共同探讨说明文和议论文的阅读方法和解题策略。我们从说明文入手。这里老师总结了说明文的文体特征。大家都是做过很多题目的，可以称得上是有经验的阅读者。相信这些似曾相识的文字一定可以印证你头脑当中关于说明文的某些印象。说明文是以说明为主要表达方式来解说客观事物和抽象事理，从而给人知识。这种知识呢，可能来自于相关科学研究的资料，也可能是亲自实践调查和考察的结果，都具有严谨的科学性。为了把事情说明白，就必须要把握事物的特征，进而解释事物的本质属性。即不仅要说明是什么 what， 还要说明为什么 why， 有时呢还要解答怎么办 how 的问题。这里有一个英文版的解释，我们一起读一下，进一步去体会和理解说明文的特征。 It is a type of informational test that tells something about a topic or an idea to the readers. The purpose is to inform, explain, describeor define the subject. We will find some facts, examples, supporting details, and sometimes the author's own opinion in the test. 啊，我们可以看到它的目的。那么以及我们经常会遇见一些事实，看到一些事实、例子，还有支撑性的细节。有时候呢，也会有作者自己的观点，并不是说说明文就不存在作者的观点。那么说明文的典型特征之一，中心突出。第二呢，就是它每一段往往都会有一个段落中心句 topic sentence， 啊，其余的内容都是在支撑这个段落的中心和主题。那当然，我们放大来说，从篇章的角度呢，各段的主题其实也是在从不同的角度来解释篇章的主旨。好，在中考的这个考场上，经常光顾的几类说明文，一个是研究汇报类 reporting researches or studies。那第二类是提供建议类 offering tips and suggestions to help people do something better in daily life. 那么还有一个就是解释现象类 explaining phenomenon. Of course, the purpose is to explain. 啊，比如说我解释一个 peer pressure 同伴压力，对吧？啊，这种现象。好，那今天呢，我们将专注于科学研究类，也说是第一类的学习。请同学们啊，现在找到这个学案的Why do teens take risk 这篇文章，那我们需要完成相关的题目和挑战。在这之前呢，有这样一些 warming up questions you need to think about by yourself. Teenagers are in wonderful blossom of adolescence. So are you a teenager who loves taking risks? Why do you like it? Or why don't you like it? Do you think taking risks is a good thing for teenagers?那同学们已经做完了，接下来呢，咱们从梳理结构入手来剖析这篇文章。浏览全篇之后，我们可以发现文章的题目正是这篇文章的话题 Why do teens take risks? 这是这个文章的话题。那第一段呢，只有一句话 What might be the reasons for teenager crime? 我可以把它看成一个 hook， 就是一个 eye-catching point to attract the attention of readers。那么在这里是抛出了一个相关的社会话题、社会问题、青少年犯罪的问题，进而呢引出此文的核心问题 ：Why do teens take risk？ 好，那接下来我们关注二到三段啊。Paragraph 2 and 3 are mainly about the finding of the research. So paragraph 2 focuses on the idea that they do these things because they enjoy the thrill of taking a risk. 所以说这里的这个 keyword 是 thrill。他们就喜欢冒险带来的这种刺激。那 paragraph 3, according to age, the reason why teenagers take risk is because they choose to do so. 也说他们是选择这样去做，是自己主动这样做的。好， paragraph 4 and 5, it is about the process. In other words, how is the research performed? According to paragraph 4,We have got the participants are these boys and men between the ages of 9 and 35. So they are asked to play computer games. As for data collection, 数据收集，这个数据不一定说非得指这种具象的数字。咱们说在研究当中呢，收集的相关信息，然后对这个信息再进行分类啊、整理啊，包括这个分析，那最后得出结论，这些信息其实就是 data， 对吧？这里也是泛指了 data collection。那么这里收集的就是关于参与者他的满意程度，对吧？To what extent, to what degree are they satisfied or unsatisfied toward the result of the game? So emotional responses are measured here. And the method is recording. Okay. Paragraph 6 and 7 is about the further analysis of the findings. So according to paragraph 6, teens tend to take bigger risks because they enjoy the lucky escape situation.Lucky escape, what does that mean? 我们只要翻译成中文呢，这个 lucky escape 是侥幸逃脱。It means you don't need to suffer the punishment after doing something risky or harmful or wrong. So lucky escape, 侥幸逃脱了，啊，幸运逃脱。Okay, paragraph 7. They take risks because they enjoy the thrill of a risky situation more than any other.Age groups, not because they are unable to do what. 那这里我们显然是要说这个 weighing up the pros and the cons of the decisions, 不是因为他们不能够权衡利弊。所以你要把这个空填精准呢，需要大家哈对这个第七段，包括前边呼应的遥相呼应的这个第三段，都在传递同样的一个意思。对这两段的这种句间关系、句句关系、句与句之间的关系，你要把握清楚。那你比如说第三段里边提到的 The reason why teenagers take risk is not a problem with foreseeing the consequences. It is more because they choose to take those risks. 这个对比其实也是说到了问题不在于说他能否预见后果。那么根据第七段咱们知道其实他是擅长去权衡利和弊的。Pros and cons 利和弊对吧 advantages and disadvantages 所以问题不在于他预见不了这种冲动的惩罚和后果是吧而在于呢他主动追求这样一种 thrill、OK 下一段 Paragraph 8 and 9 The importance or you can also see the meaning the application all of them are acceptable words here so Paragraph 8The importance for public health work and for families. And in paragraph 9, it talks about the necessity, given the severe, the serious social reality of teens, crime, and death cases. 所以这两段其实是在说这个研究它的意义，它的这种价值，或者它应用的领域，包括 public health work, families. 那么这一段其实第九段吧，它是在谈这样一种必要性对吧因为现实是很严峻的青少年犯罪的这个现象是非常猖狂的是亟待我们去做相关研究的所以重要性必要性其实都是在探索它的 value 价值好了那我们做一个小结吧接下来我们来看一下好第一个图 How to design a research project那么这里说我们在设计一个研究项目的时候该考虑哪些 elements 呢考虑哪些元素呢像这个图表里边提到的 background and purpose, 背景和目的研究对象 subjects, methods, 研究方法 procedures, 也就是 process, finding and analysis, conclusion and application, sometimes there's also suggestions for further study. 我们再看一下科普类说明文的常见架构。往往为了吸引这个读者的注意也是为了这个开门见山一开始呢就会把这个研究的结果向读者呈现也就是说是我们可以看到这个图表是从 what are the new findings 开始的从 what 开始的那么接下来呢也会探讨这个 how 那么包括 data analysis 的这个分析以及 importance value meaning 那最后呢可能会重述 conclusion 那么也会提一些 suggestions 因为只有这样呢就是第一些 suggestions 我们才能对未来进一步的研究提供这个指引和建议这样研究呢才能环环相扣步步推进我们才能站在巨人的肩膀上去从事科研工作好 What is the main idea of the passage? 我们都能够抓取 这个研究它的一个 finding， 它的结论在开始也呈现了。所以这块呢，只要就是你把意思传递出来，那么语法确保正确就可以了啊。Teens are more likely to take risks because they enjoy the thrill of a risky situation, especially when they have a lucky escape. 所以关键词 more likely to take risks, enjoy the thrill, and also lucky escape. Can also mention it specifically. OK， 捕捉细节这部分呢，我们不再一一的去讲每个题目，大家可以核对一下答案，看一下关键的细节，你是不是已经捕捉到了呢？如果没有做正确，那么大家参考蓝色部分这个文本的证据、信息句、解锁句来做出。接下来我们进入词汇练习部分，这部分题目的正确答案是 E、A、C。那第一个 alcohol 是指酒精，第二个 responses refers to an answer or a reaction， 第三个 pros and cons。利与弊对应的是 advantages and disadvantages， 这也是一个多义短语，比如 debate 语境当中，支持观点、反对观点、支持者、反对者，我们都可以用 pros and cons 来表达。好，最后一个思考问题留给大家。Since you have got some knowledge on why teens like taking risks, can you come up with some possible methods to reduce teenager crime from this perspective?同学们可以畅所欲言，自圆其说就可以。在这儿呢，老师也贡献一个角度，比如我们根据文章的研究发现，从源头上解决。本身 teenager crime 的一大因素是 are more likely to take risks. And then why do they like taking risks? Because they enjoy the thrill of lucky escape. 所以这里我们是否可以找到一些疏泄的办法，找到一些 alternatives?How to satisfy teens' pursuit of thrill in a positive way. For example, reading books about adventure or doing competitive sports. 另外，作为青少年的监护人、父母，以及在成长过程当中起关键助力作用的老师，是不是也可以发挥其监督和防控作用呢？ For example, they can pay closer attention to what teens are doing and thinking about.Offering timely guide, warning, and monitoring will also be of great help in reducing teenager crime. 这样我们就从疏和堵两个方向来思考这个问题。相信同学们在发散思维之后，也一定会有自己有力的见解。好，接下来我们进入实战演练部分。这是2017年北京市中考题的第一篇。大家现在按一下暂停键，然后把这篇阅读理解做完，然后我们一起来剖析题目，解读文章。好，我们来看一下这篇文章呢，它的这个用词啊，还有观点都是比较抽象，但是只要大家能够把 research 常见的几个要素理清楚，把这个关系捋顺，其实你是可以把握住这个文章的关键的啊，比如说。还可以看到划线的部分，第一段 This is the main conclusion of study， 那么这句话其实就提示前边是一个 main conclusion， 大家需要重点关注的，对吧？主旨段落，那么主题句，那接下来是揭示它论点的，揭示这个主要观点的啊。那么接下来 The study was performed among 253 school children in Spain， 显然这个地方从研究对象开始说起，参与者，那么我们知道它其实结合后边的理解是在讲 how was the research performed， 对吧？啊，你包括后边两段 ，This is the first study that shows the association between long-term exposure to green space and brain structure。那还有这一句 ，The findings show that long-term exposure to greenness is positively associated with white and gray matter volumes in several parts of the brain。这些段落主题句或者说段落中心句，就能让我们尽快的去明晰这个实验研究的这个 finding， 对吧？以及对 finding 的这个 analysis。好，那这是这三大部分的内容。好，接下来我们继续往后看啊，这里依然是在进行 research data analysis。那么这一部分呢，是在说明这个 why is the research finding important？ 对吧？包括最后也提到了 suggestions for the further study。And according to it, researchers need to examine differences according to the nature and the quality of green space. 啊，好，那我们现在来看题目。这个题目的第一题，老师不再赘述了哈，刚才已经分析过那一段了，是讲 how the study was performed。这个一个是需要大家啊对这个说明文常见的这样一个架构有整体的把握，那同时呢，也需要你对这一段进行详细的总结。那我们再来看第二，好，我们再来看第二个题啊，第二个题这个 prompt 大家找到这个第六段的内容。那我们根据第六段的内容。可以看到这样一些信息句啊，一起来读一下。Humans are believed to be tied to nature. Playing in greener areas offers children opportunities to search and learn. Accordingly, green space is thought to prompt important exercise in discovery, creativity, and risk-taking. This exercise in turn positively influences brain development. 这个题目当中啊，对应的信息句，这个 accordingly， 那么这个副词。它揭示了这个句间关系，它是因此于是的意思，所以前因后果。那么后边这个 in turn 反过来，那又是在揭示这样两个关系。所以呢，我们就可以确定 brain space 它和这个 exercise 它们是相互促进、相互影响的关系，对吧？这个，所以我们要选 B 选项啊。我们经常当这个鼓励、促进、鼓舞的这个意思来讲。好。好，我们再看第三题，最后一题。What can we learn from the passage? 那么从这一段，从这个文章，我们能够得出什么结论呢？或者我们能够推断出什么来呢？好，第一个 ，working memory influences white and green matter in the brain。这个 working memory， 大家在前面读到的时候，其实是能发现的啊，在这个段尾。那么它是属于这个 green space， 就这种绿色空间，这影响因素所导致的一个结果，所以它是因变量的一个角色，而非句子当中就是这个选项当中提到的，它是一个自变量的功能和角色，所以显然它是不对的啊，因果是颠倒的。那么这是一个啊，就说是绿色空间呢，其实是可以改善这种 white and green matter， 那么同时肯定它能影响你的这个 working memory， 它是一个因变量的角色。好，那 B 选项。Stress the importance of changing the environment. 它的确是提到了这个绿色空间的重要性，这种环境里边有绿色，对吧？但是呢，不能过度推断出说是 changing the environment 啊，这是一个。那么第 C 选项我们可以看到，这个 out of Spain 显然与这个句子当中的与这个文本当中的信息是不一致的，是冲突的。这个研究是 in Spain， 这 participants come from Spain， 都是来自于西班牙的啊，所以 D 选项 living in greener neighborhoods benefits children in brain development， 也就是全文一直在强调的一个 finding， 那整个文章也是围绕着这种 finding 展开的论述，对吧？好，那咱们这一课时就结束了，相信大家已经收获了更多的小工具来解说来这个解读说明文。当然这只是一个锦上添花的效果，希望大家呢还是在实战演练当中去收获更多的体验，直至你呢能够在说明文解读上变得更加的强大。嗯，谢谢大家。Boys and girls, today our focus will shift to another two types of expository essays.Which also visit our reading test frequently. 今天呢，我们将关注另外两类经常光顾中考考场的说明文类型：说明文、提建议类 （offering tips） 和解释现象类 （explaining the phenomenon）。那首先是提建议类，这一类呢，往往是传递某个方面的技巧和窍门。可想而知，从传递知识这一目的上，就决定了它的风格。是语言简练，结构偏清晰的，那么外形呢也比较容易辨认，我们经常见到如图所示的这种结构，按点排列，条目鲜明。今天呢，我们就来尝试阅读这样一篇文章。我们常说，人生活在关系网当中，矛盾不可避免，那面对冲突， 我们该从何下手，又如何解决呢？每个人都会指责别人，这也仿佛是最简单的办法。It seems blaming others is the easiest thing to do for people in a conflict. But it is the worst solution, 可能是最坏的方案，对吧？ Reflecting your own mistake and apologizing sometimes is the real start of rethinking problem and changing the negative into something positive. So let us read an article titled When and How to Apologize. Now guys, you're supposed to go to your handout and finish the exercise there. Okay, it's time to share our answers together and welcome back. The first task is to choose the proper subtitle for each blank. Let's have a look at them one by one. The first should be take the responsibility. Actually, we can find the word responsibility here. And taking the responsibility means admitting to ourselves that we have offended someone, or admitting that we have done wrong and accepting responsibility for our own actions. The second one should be explain. So here is a question to explain what to the other person, to the other side. Yeah, sometimes we are expected to show that we didn't mean to do harm. We didn't do it on purpose. 我们不是故意这样去做的。At the same time, we need to show that we take our mistake seriously, and there should also be the recognition that our actions have caused the problem for the other person. So that's the second part. Let's focus on the next one. It should be to show your regret. Why we need to show our regret? Because the other side might need to say that we have suffered too. So there is a specific situation where you can say, I felt bad the minute I told your secret. I'm ashamed of myself. 所以这也是一个处事的技巧。我们让对方看到我们其实也很伤心，我们也很难过，也很后悔。这其实是让对方放下芥蒂的一种办法，也能让他们更快的去原谅我们。Okay, next one. We should put repair the damage here. Please turn your focus to words like offer to fix it, make it up. These three express the similar meaning. 要一些弥补性的措施，要修复你们的关系。There is a specific situation, an example, where you might say, I'll try to keep my mouth shut in the future. Meantime, let me buy you a cup of coffee. And another way to repair the damage is to send a note or a small gift. Of course, you can have your own alternatives to show your regret, to repair the damage, to offer the makeup action. Okay, the next part is use the good timing. Time here is a verb, 定时。So timing 它的动名词形式，对吧？我们要选择合适的时间，合适的契机。Then here is a central question. What is a good timing? It depends on different situation, right? If you are in the conflict for little things, for example, you need to say sorry right now, right away, immediately, and don't wait. But on the other hand, if you have done something more serious, like insulting a friend, your apology should be more thoughtful, more careful. A quick apology might seem phony. And take the time to sit down and look the person in the eye and apologize honestly. So time can be a sign of honesty here. Okay, last paragraph. Remember, it's not about who won or lost. It's about keeping a strong relationship. So that's the central theory, which has governed the whole passage. All of the actions the author has offered to us. All of the strategies. 好，我们来看一下第二组题目 ,Answer the short questions. 那么这是我们中考任务型阅读的考察形式。这类题呢可能难度不会太高，但是需要大家去关注文本当中的细节信息，根据设问里边的关键词锁定信息句，找到解锁句的正确位置，然后呢用合乎语法规则的形式来作答。那比如第一个问题， Why is it important to apologize right away in most cases? 根据这个 right away, 我们能够快速的锁定到第一段的最后一句这个信息句啊。That solves the small problem and keeps it from getting bigger. Keep from is equal to prevent from, stop from. 所以这个核心就说阻止它升级，阻止矛盾加剧，这是我们化解问题的一个理念，就是大事化小，小事化了，而不是说让小的矛盾加剧升级。好，第二个， Why do some people find it hard to apologize? 那么这个对应的是我们第二段的第一句，它的答案是 Because many of us are ashamed or have too much pride, so it's the problem of ego we always talk about. 也说是大家经常会说到的面子问题啊，我感到很害羞，或者我自尊心特别强，那就会不利于这个道歉，或者不利于这个矛盾的解决。好，下一个。What might be the purpose of saying words like I felt bad the minute I told your secret? I'm ashamed of myself. 那么这个显然是在这个 Show your regret 这个标题之下的段落。那么当时呢，我们还说过这个 Show your regret 是整个这一段的一个 central idea, main idea。那么这是一个目的。那么还有一个目的呢，就是这一段的第一句。从另一方的角度来说 ,the other person needs to say that you have suffered too. 所以说这个小技巧呢也是让两个站在对立面的人他们能够走到同一个立场。那这也是冰释前嫌和解决问题的一个开始。好，下一个。In order to make the apology complete, what should we do besides apologizing? 显然它对应的是 we should correct the injury, we should offer to fix it, we should offer the makeup actions, 都可以啊，提出一些弥补的措施。好，下一个。What is the main idea of the second paragraph from the bottom? 那我们看一下，倒数第二段。幸运的是呢，这个 subtitle 已经把这个 main idea 传递出来了，就是这个 use the good timing。但是 what is a good timing? It depends on different situations. In small cases, you need to apologize right now. But for more serious problems, you need to be more careful and more thoughtful because the time we wait is a sign of honesty, is a sign of sincerity. 那时候等待这个时间呢，是在体现你的这种深思熟虑，或者说你的道歉的真诚啊。好，最后一个题目。Use your own words to talk about your own understanding of the last paragraph. 那我们来看一下最后一段啊。一句话 ,Remember, it's not about who won or lost. It's about keeping the strong relationship, keeping the strong friendship. 所以这个我们之前也谈过，它其实是作者整篇文章的一个指导理念。It is this theory from which all the strategies offered started.So how to understand it? When we apologize, we should focus on rebuilding the strong relationship rather than determine who is the winner or who is the loser because there is not a winner or loser in the conflict or in the quarrel. Both of the parties are losers, right? Until the conflict can be solved in a proper way. 好，接下来我们来看第三组题目。Rewrite the sentences below. Use the words or expressions from the article that have the similar meanings of the underlined parts of the sentences. 那么这一部分语言点的锤炼，老师希望同学们能够掌握多样化的表达，让自己的表达方式在难度上适度的升级，逐渐的升级。这是我们写作的一个训练目的。比如第一个。If you stay angry with someone, a small problem may turn into a bigger one.生某人的气。Here the target phrase in the test is hold a grudge. Grudge, 心生怨恨，怀恨在心。啊，它可以等于这个 hatred, H-E-T-R-E-D。那么这个是 hold a grudge 这个短语的一个锤炼。那么第二个 ,don't be embarrassed about your behavior if you have been rude to someone.We can also say you don't be ashamed of your behavior if you have offended someone. You have done something rude, really bad, or hurtful, harmful to the other side. And the third one, agree that you did something wrong admit that your action was hurtful. So admit, agree, accept, 大家比较熟悉意思啊。Accept, 接受 ,admit, 承认 ,agree, 同意。这三个呢，他们是属于那种 share part of the meaning, but in some cases, they can replace each other. 第四个啊， tell the other person that you have felt pain. The synonym is suffered. Yeah, that's the synonym, 同义词啊。好，下一个， if the damage isn't clear, ask the person, how can I correct the injury I caused you? Here, clear is equal to obvious.How can I correct the injury I caused you? Another word, what can I do to make it up to you? Okay, next one. If you say or treat a friend with disrespect or abuse, your apology should not be forced. In the original text, you can also say, if you insult a friend, your apology should not be phony. Phony, that is the opposite side of sincerity and honesty.那在这里呢，就是告诉我们，我们要慎重思考之后再去道歉，以表诚意啊。那接下来我们进入实战演练部分。今天呢，我们一起来做一篇解释现象类的说明文 ，Explaining the Phenomenon。它对应的呢是17年的北京中考第一篇。现在请同学们来完成题目。好，相信大家已经做完了。那接下来呢？我们先来分析一下这篇文章，看第一段 ，Say you're sitting around with some friends playing video games, and someone mentions a game that happens to be one of your favorites. Oh, that is game is easy, so not worth the time. One of your friends says, the others agree. Although you enjoy the game quite a lot, not wanting to agree with them, you go along with the crowd. 所以这里是。展现了一个生活当中的场景，举了一个小例子。To cite an example to say what is to express what is peer pressure, right? 那么第二段我们看作者进一步的去解释 what is peer pressure. So the first two paragraphs is targeted at displaying what is peer pressure. 那么接下来 We are all influenced by our peers at any age.For teens, as school and other activities take you away from home, you may spend more time with your friends than with your family. As you become more independent, your peers naturally play a greater role in your life. 所以这里呢，可以看出来，是从 why 的角度 ，why is there peer pressure? 来阐释了这个存在 peer pressure 的原因，为什么我们会就是受这种 peer pressure 的影响。啊，导致我们行为上的改变。好，下一段。This shows that teens may find it more difficult to control risky behavior. 那么这里显然是在说对这个行为的影响可能更难呢，更难去控制这种冒险性的行为。那接下来这一段，第一句 ，topic sentence。Just as people can influence us to make unwise choices, they can also influence us to make good ones. 那这里有一个转折，显然 ，how does peer pressure influence us? 那么不止呢谈到了这种 negative ones, but also discuss the positive ones, the beneficial effects in this paragraph. And the last one.While we are all this influenced by those around us, the decision to act or not is up to us. So when it comes to decision making, the choice is up to you. 那显然是在说 ，How are people supposed to deal with it? 啊，我们是怎么来对待它 ？How to treat the peer pressure?好，那我们来看一下题目。第一个 ，According to the passage, Dr. Cassie probably agrees that teenagers. 好，我们来看一下啊。那么根据这个 Dr. Cassie， 我们找到了这个段落，锁定了这个段落之后啊，大家可以看到蓝色部分其实是这个正确答案的信息句。那么首先说了是一个人的时候的情况 ，Teens are very quick and accurate in making decisions.However, 这个连词揭示了接下来句子的这个转折关系。那么提到了 有 peers 就是有同伴陪伴的时候，那说到这个蓝色部分的啊 ，the number of risks teens took more than doubled when their friends were watching compared with when they played alone. This shows that teens may find it more difficult to control risky behavior when their friends are around. 所以说，咱们得出的答案应该是 D 选项。这个 double 是具体说它是几倍。那么在这里说，朋友在身边注视时冒险的这种行为数量呢，是独自一人时的两倍，所以我们选的是 C。好，第一个 like to play driving games with their friends 并没有说他这个喜好，那包括第二个喜好也没有谈到。Are slow in making decisions when they are on their own， 这显然是一个错误的对应。你看这里是 quick 的 accurate 更精准、更迅速。好，这是第一题，我来看第二题。What do the underlined words in the heat of the moment in paragraph four probably mean？ 那么我们再是根据这个划线部分找到段落。我们来看一下啊，那往往像这种猜词的题目、猜意思的题目，我们最关注的就是这个题目所在的句子以及这个句子的左邻右舍，包括句子之间的关系，来断定它的含义。有的时候肯定也要结合着这一段的 topic sentence 中心意思、中心思想去这个考虑。那像这一句说的啊，However, when they make decisions in the heat of the moment。Or in social situations, their decisions are often influenced by factors like peers. 所以这里是提到了一个是在社交场合之下，那么另一种场合是需要我们猜测的。当然，这个字面意思也很重要。那好多时候，这个真正的意思呢，其实从字面意思延伸过来的。比如说到 heat，我们最常见的意思就是热量、热度，对吧？是这个意思。那可能现在大家判断不出来，再往后看，你会发现这一句话。This shows that teens may find it more difficult to control risky behavior when their friends are around or in situations where they are extremely hungry。所以你会发现，其实这两个是对应的。那么一个是 when their friends are around，社交场合就是 social situations。那么还有一个 in situations where they are extremely hungry。那么这个对应的其实就是 heat of the moment。那么大家再考虑一下，结合着字面意思。那么我们不只说天气的炎热，环境方面，我们还可以指人的情绪比较热，尤其是在人激动的时候，或是在人比较愤怒的时候，那这个情绪上的这种狂热，我们说这种激动啊，这种愤怒啊，也可以用这个 heat 来表达，它属于一种延伸的，也是比较形象的说法。好，再看第三题，What can we learn from the passage？First, teens are eager to be different from their peers。那你像这一项，我们在讲同伴压力，其实从这篇文章当中，我们看到的是迫于同伴压力，孩子们呢会有一种趋同的选择。所以这个 be different, eager to be different，第一他也没有提到是不是想这样，第二一个呢，与整篇文章的这种意思其实是也和谐的。好，第二个，peer pressure does more harm than good to teens。作者的确是提到了 good effects and bad effects，but he didn't rank them，并没有让他们比较出来谁高谁低，谁多谁少，对吧？好，第三个，peer pressure has the effects on both teens and adults。那么这个反而我们能找到这个新戏剧。第三段，We are all influenced by our peers at any age。那这就是说，both adults and teens，yes they are influenced by the peer pressure。And the next one, teens think it's challenging to get good grades at school。那么大家根据这个 good grades 可以找到对应的这个信息段落，在第五段他说到了啊，A teen might join in a volunteer project because his or her friends are doing it, or get good grades because his or her friends think getting good grades is important。其实说在这里并不是 challenging 的效果，而是 encouraging。对吧？当自己的同伴，那么觉得获得好成绩重要的时候，你也会去这样做。这也是在谈积极影响的这一段落当中说到了这一细节。好，第四题，Which of the following should be the title for the passage？我们看第一个，Peer pressure, is it necessary to deal with it？首先，这不是全文的重点。那么再次呢，最后一段说了，作者告诉我们 how to deal with it。 We should make our own choices. It's up to us. 那么第二个 ，Is it possible to get away from it? 也没有重点去探讨，而且作者呈现的是 We are all influenced by peer pressure. 那它是普遍存在的，都对不同的群体都是有影响力的。好，第三个 ，It's benefits to teens and friend making. 但这个 benefits 它就不能够覆盖到讲这种负面影响的段落和部分。好，第四个 ，peer pressure is influence on teens and decision making. 这个 influence 是一个中性的词，符合全文的基调，而且呢，全文也一直在说 decision making 行为的这种改变、做决定的影响，对吧？所以我们要选啊 D 选项，包括老师标注的这些蓝色部分，就呈现了反两面的一个论述。作者的这种基调就是既肯定它的 positive one， also affirm the negative one。好，那么对于题目类的题目，找这个选题目类的这种题，咱们应该思考哪些因素呢？我们肯定是要找到全文的话题中心以及它的主旨。那怎么找呢？往往有一些关键的部位需要大家去特殊注意，比如说是主旨段落、开头或者是结尾。那有的时候没有明显的主旨段落，我们怎么办呢？我们就只能是逐个的分析每段的大意。每段的 topic sentence， 然后呢，我们再考虑段与段之间的关系，理清楚之后呢，进行一个综合的考量。当然，贯穿全文的关键词也能够明显的告诉我们探讨的话题。所以，既要话题中心，那么既要切中话题的中心，又要跟观点完全吻合，这就需要大家找到一个主旨啊，然后再去选择题目。好，相信大家呢，今天已经学习了在解释说明类。解释类说明文以及提供建议类说明文的一些解读工具，但接下来呢，希望大家在实战演练当中，在不同语境的磨练之下，再壮大自己的这个工具箱，同时呢，强大自己的理解。Hello, boys and girls. For this class, our job is to explore argumentation.So how to read argumentative essays in a scientific way, and how to get a high score in this part. 这节课呢，我们就围绕这两个目标来探索。议论文是以议论为主要表达方式，通过摆事实、讲道理、直接表达自己观点和主张的文体，以理服人。议论文的三要素是论点、论据、论证 ,argument, evidence, and reasoning.当然，在体系比较完善的议论文当中，围绕核心论点，往往还会设置几个支撑论点。As the picture shows, there are supporting points 1, 2, and 3, and the reasoning methods are various and diverse. Evidence in the test is usually displayed in forms including facts, examples, data, and quotes.Now we are going to read an article titled Prove Ourselves. You need to go to the handout and finish the exercise. Okay, it's time to share our answers. The first task is to divide the article into three parts. Scientifically speaking, we can divide them into three parts. Paragraph 1, 2, 3 form the first group. The main idea is boy students.Are active and behave naturally in class, while girl students seem nervous and cautious in class. That is the result of the author's observation, the difference on personality between girls and boys. The second part, paragraph 4 to 6, form the second group, and the main idea is difference between girls and boys cannot decide our future.And the girls need to prove that they can do things as well as boys, even better than boys. Okay, the last paragraph, the ending, the concluding part. The main idea is, girls, do not complain without doing anything. Let us change people's negative opinions about girls with our own actions. Here comes the second question. What is the argument of the passage?In order to figure it out, please first ask yourself, among the three points listed here, which is the central point and which are subpoints? It's not hard to determine the second one is the central point, because the first one is to serve for or prepare for the second one, that is to build a basis. Point three is a summary and a restatement of the second one, so we can combine the second and the three points for the argument. That should be differences between girls and boys cannot decide their future.Girls need to prove themselves through actions instead of complaining. Now it's time to focus on the details. The first question, why will boys argue with someone who disagrees with them? It's not hard to find out the evidence in the original test. So the answer should be because they are confident and they think their answers are the best ones.And they try to persuade that person to agree with them. Okay, the second question, what is the difference between boys and girls when they make a mistake? According to the test, boys often find an excuse for their mistakes, but the girls will feel disappointed and think it is their fault. It seems girls are more likely to blame themselves. So here is a...stark contrast against the boys. But in your daily life, is that the case? According to your own understanding and observation, is that the case? It depends, right? Different. Okay. The third one. What can girls do to change other people's negative opinions about them and get more attention? This question is discussed in paragraph 5.So we can summarize the answer in this way. They should change their own attitude to believe in themselves and be confident. So the key to solving this problem is to change the attitude. And the next question, what should girls do in order to prove that they are as capable as boys? This question is discussed in a detailed way in paragraph 6. The answer should be,They should recognize their shortcomings and try their best to overcome them. 应该意识到自己的缺点，去克服它们。Okay, the next one. What does the author advise girls to do to get rid of sexual discrimination at the end of the passage? 怎么去克服这种从自身的角度，作为女性群体的这个角度，去克服这种性别歧视呢？ So the key point is,taking actions through own efforts instead of complaining. Okay, next part. Language points. Choose the answer. Use the context to help you guess the meaning of the underlined words. The first one, complain. Complain means to say that you are annoyed, you are dissatisfied, you are unhappy about something or someone. This is to relay one's bad feelings, but sometimes it'sof no use in changing the situation. But to some degree, it can change the person's mood, change the person's mental state, right? And the second one, confidence. Yes, it is a kind of quality of being certain of your abilities or of having trust in people, plans, or the future. And next one, negative, is the opposite of positive. The answer should be considering only the bad side.Pessimistic 是悲观的 lacking enthusiasm or hope. Okay, next one, capable. Capable is equal to able here. So 我们经常说能力 ability, here we can say capability, 就是表示能力的意思啊。Okay, next question. What are the sentences you like for your own use in the future writing?Everybody has a different taste, and for me, the taste is actions speak louder than words. Facts are the most powerful weapon to fight against discrimination. I like this sentence best because I think this one is very simple, but it is in depth, 是有深度的。我们经常在汉语里说情胜于言。那么这里 facts are the most powerful weapon, 一个比喻的说法。非常好用的，希望大家呢能够借鉴这样的语言，或者借鉴你挑选出来的语言，应用到自己的写作当中。 增彩添色。好，又到了我们实战演练的时刻了。今天呢，我们将一起完成一篇议论文的中考真题，试题来源于2016年北京中考的地篇，大家先自行完成，稍后我们共同探讨。好，相信同学们已经完成了，我们再来一起阅读一遍这篇文章。首先看题目 ,Should children be allowed to get bored? 这是一个问句。在此呢，我们知道文章探讨的议题就是 Should children be allowed to get bored? 那因此我们对这个整篇的文章也有一个预判了。作者呢可能会在文中发表自己对这一问题的观点，并且是阐述理由。那我们再来印证一下，读第一段。Children need time to stand and stare. They should be allowed to get bored so that they can develop their ability to be creative. 那在这里呢，第一段提出论点，直抒胸臆。那么他强调呢，其实这种无聊的时间呢，反而是有利于孩子们发展他们的创造力。好，我们再看第二段。Children are expected by their parents to be reading the textbook all the time.However, research shows that may hamper the development of their imagination, while boredom can give them opportunities to develop creativity.
在这里呢，从反面通过比较和对比再次强化论点。为什么说是反面呢？我们可以看到这个 boredom， 那么它对应的其实就是它的反面，就是一种 reading a textbook all the time。因为你这样的话就抢占了这个 boredom 的时间。那么在这里说到 reading the textbook all the time can hamper the development of their imagination, while boredom can give the opportunities and create the positive effects。所以这里从反面再次强化了论点。那我们再来看第三段，开头 ，Boredom
is often linked with loneliness, but a writer said boredom had helped her in developing.Her mind.
所以这里我们可以看到哈，恰逢这一句呢，就是第三段的 topic sentence。读完这个段落中心句，我们就能 get 到这段的主干大意，是一个作家的例子来论证 boredom can develop one's mind。所以刚才这三段，直抒胸臆提出论点，从反面再次强化论点，举例子。那同理，我们看下一段。他又举了这个画家的例子来论证 boredom 的好处。我们看最后一句 ,bored but free, he spent hours looking out of the window, watching the changing clouds and seasons. Harry filled up his free time with what he liked. He became creative because he could think freely.
那么在这里呢也进一步解释了为什么 boredom 是可以提升创造力的。因为有一个前提条件，只有拥有这种 boredom， 像这个画家这样，他可以呢做自己喜欢的事情，他才能够自由的想象。所以这也是补充了一个条件。那么自由想象呢，它是可以促进创造。
好，下一段 ，Dr. Belton is an expert on the effects of emotions on learning. Boredom could be an uncomfortable feeling, she said, but some young people cannot deal with that boredom creatively.So sometimes they may break a classroom window or drive a car out for a mad race.
那这一段呢是引用了专业人士的观点和话语，补充说明了，那么对待 boredom 呢是有一些不积极的或者是破坏性的这种方式和行为啊，比如说是 break a classroom window 这种。那么接下来下一段
，Usually when children have nothing to do, they would turn on the TV, the computer, or the phone. Their time on these things has increased.Yet they need to have time to think about their experiences through play or just watching the world around them.
所以在这里呢，就提出了一些比较积极的建设性的对待 boredom 的方式。那比如说他提到了 play， 还有前面讲到 artist， 我们提到的 do what you like， 那还有是 watch the world around you。那这样呢，我们就可以去 think about your experiences， think freely。那我们再看下一段。
It is this kind of thinking that can inspire the imagination. On the other hand, the TV or phone may cut short in the thinking process. That can be harmful to the development of creativity. For developing the ability to be creative, Dr. Belton advised, perhaps we need to stand and stare and stay offline from time to time. 那在这里 cut short 会缩短这个思考的过程。我们知道思考的过程、学习的过程是有的时候是不能抄近路的，不能走捷径的啊，这也不利于发展我们的这个创造力。那最后一句话 ，perhaps we need to stand and stare。我们知道这一句也是照应开头 ，stand and stare 第二次出现，照应开头的一种比较别致的写作手法，首尾呼应啊 ，stay off life from time to time， 要有一些远离这个，远离我们的这 internet， 远离网络，远离电脑和手机的离线时间。这个不只是对 children， 我们知道现在对成人这个低头族来说也是需要注意的一个事情。好，接下来我们来看题目。好，第一题 ，What does the word happier in paragraph two probably mean？ 那我们再重读一下第二自然段。Children are expected by their parents to be reading the textbook all the time. However, research shows it may hamper the development of their imagination, while boredom can give them opportunities to develop creativity. 那么在这里这个 hamper。我们看到它到底是什么意思呢？它需要我们厘清呢前后的 hyper 前后的关系，就是一个是 it， 一个是 the development of imagination。那么首先我们需要明确这个 it 指代的是什么，显然就是前面对立的一面 reading the textbook all the time， 然后我们再结合着论点去理解。另外呢，从连词 however 转折以及这个 while 在此表示这个对仗关系、对比关系，我们就能抓住这两处的转折和对比，最后选出选项 A， slow down。而这个 keep up with， go beyond， give rise to， 都没有一个阻碍的意思，或是一个减缓的意思在。那么这个 go beyond 呢是超越，那么这个是赶上，give rise to 是增加。好，我们再看第二个。The writer talks about these two writers and artists to do what？ 那么刚才呢，我们分析过结构，我们知道这一部分呢是属于举例论证来支撑论点的，所以正确答案是 show effects of boredom on developing creativity。当然，他提到的角度可能不一样，但是都是在说有利于 develop mind, develop imagination, so as to strengthen one's creativity。这样一个角度，围绕这个角度来讲的。好，接下来第三个 ，What can we learn from the passage？ 好，这个题呢，我们是选 A。Boredom provides children with space to think freely。那这个影响呢，也是发展想象力、创造力的这个一个必备条件，就是我们能够自由的想象。那我们再来看一下其他选项的错点是如何设置的。我们来看 B。It's much better for children to be busy than to be bored。 那显然这个 B 是属于论调就与这个主旨论点冲突的啊，所以这个属于一个比较明显的错误。那 C 选项 Boredom helps children deal with difficulties properly。 那么在这里我们可以看一下啊，它属于一个偷换概念的错误。那我们说可以发展孩子的创造力和这种 deal with difficulties 它是不能画等号的啊。好， D 选项 It's boring for children to think about their experiences。 那么这个 D 选项也是判断有误。那对于这个无聊这方面，我们在文中看到的是只有拥有更多的无聊的空闲时间，孩子们才会有思考经历的这种机会和精力。而对于这个思考他们经历本身并没有说提到它是否是无聊，这也不是我们讨论的主题。好，议论文的课时到此为止，相信大家可以通过接下来的备考收获更加丰富的阅读体验，更加宝贵的灵感，让我们的阅读更加透彻到位，让我们的解题更加游刃有余。